These printers are so similar, it can make the decision of buying one or the other incredibly difficult. In today's video, we are going to be breaking down these printers to help you decide which one you should get. The answer is not as easy as you think. Let's dive into it. The biggest reason why you might be deciding between these two printers is the price. Pricing is a bit different between the two printers. The pricing on these have increased a little bit since I last reviewed them, thanks to the new tariffs. These are still great deals nonetheless. The A1 Mini starts at $219 now, whereas the A1 comes in at $359. Adding the AMS Lite does increase the price a little bit. If you do that, you're looking at $369 for the A1 Mini and $509 for the full-size A1. Just to make it clear, I have no affiliation with Bambu Lab, and I have bought both of these printers myself at the full sale retail price. Something to keep in mind with pricing, a build plate for the A1 comes in at about $30, whereas a build plate for the A1 Mini comes in at about $15, which is half the price. That's a pretty good size difference, and we're gonna talk about that here more in just a minute. These printers are extremely similar. There's only a couple key differences that really set them apart. Both of them have full auto calibrations, which include the bed leveling, the Z offset, and they both do active flow rate compensation, which is something that the P1S and the P1P don't do. You can only get something similar to that over on the X1 Carbon, but that's significantly more expensive than these guys. Both of these printers have 10,000 millimeter per squared acceleration. They can both utilize the AMS light. Both also have the quick change nozzles, which is really nice to have. The screen on the A1 Mini is a little bit smaller than the A1, but they work great equally. There's no issues with either of them. These are still much better screens than what you find on the P1S, which is not ideal. Both printers live in the Bambu Lab ecosystem, so that way you can use their slicer and their handy app on the iPhone or iPad or Android device. And the fact that they both have it is a super big plus, and it actually makes printing with these printers a lot easier if you're new to 3D printing. Being able just to load up the app and select something to print and send it straight to the printer is super easy, and it makes these printers really accessible to everybody. There is no print speed difference between these two printers. They print at exactly the same speed according to the slicer. They are slower than the Core XY printers like the P1P, the P1S, or the X1C. However, these cost significantly less. The biggest factor here is going to be the size of the print volume. The Bambu Lab A1 can do 256 cubed. 256 by 256 by 256. On the A1 Mini, you can only do 180 by 180 by 180. If you wanna print larger items like helmets or any cosplay items, the A1 is gonna be the obvious choice here because this is just too small to really print any helmets. But if you aren't going to be printing anything huge, then the A1 Mini is a really great option to look at. You can still print a ton of stuff. I'd say about 90% of the things that I print would fit on this build plate. If space savings is a factor here, the A1 Mini is the obvious choice. The A1 is significantly larger than the A1 Mini. I'm not just talking about the build plate volume here. The A1 Mini takes up considerably less space than the full-size A1. This build plate has to go back and forward, and you actually have to have extra room so that that build plate can come all the way back, and same thing with it going all the way forward. The A1 Mini takes up significantly less amount of space. Another key point here is the A1 Mini is significantly cheaper than the A1. If you're just trying to dip your toes into 3D printing and you're not quite sure if this is something that you want to get into, the A1 Mini is a really good choice for that. This thing just works at $219. This competes with my P1S and my X1C in terms of print quality. Now, if you're getting into the taller items, the Core XY stuff does have an advantage in that, bed's moving back and forth on these bed slingers. These printers are awesome, but they do have their limits. They're great for PLA, PETG, and TPU. If you wanna print tougher materials like ASA, ABS, or even nylon, you're gonna need an enclosure or a dedicated enclosed printer. But there is another option, PCBWay. They can print in everything from standard PLA to high performance materials, even metal. If you want something beyond 3D printing, they also offer CNC milling, injection molding, and more. So if there's something you need, but you can't make it at home, PCBWay has you covered. So realistically, the only two factors of these printers is the price and the build size. Other than that, they're pretty much identical. Before you go and make your decision, you really should watch these two videos right here. In this video, I review the A1, and in this video, I review the A1 Mini. If you watch these, you're gonna get a better understanding of these printers, and you're going to be even that much more informed about making a proper choice on which one of these you should buy.